Jones. But she's been following the band literally since we started. And seeing as you were our first fan, really, it's suiting that we play my very first original song for you. Forgive how angsty it was, I was 14.
I can deal with the pain of watching you walk away. Day to day, saying I'm over you. Moving on ain't so bad. The hurt don't hurt like it used to. And I know you don't care anymore. But I just gotta tell you. Then when it rains it pours, and there's nothing I can do. Tears fall on the floor. All hell breaks loose.
Original act. Along the way, many traditions developed, including the unlikely combination of grown and often intoxicated men wearing ill-fitting hot pink tank tops.
Now, if I'm not mistaken, we actually have quite a few people in the audience who wore their pink tank tops. Oh, boys, you better get ready. This stage needs a lot more pink tank top on it. Huge for me because I'm not a musician, but we lived there basically for a week, and I got to just be present for all of it. I had to watch Jason have, you know, a rough time during his recording where he got pushed to his limit. Adam got there. I mean, Grant got a drumstick stuck in his forehead. Devin was there through the whole process, and just being there as part of a group and watching everybody struggle, but struggle towards the same goal and kind of overcome the struggle and make something happen. Honestly, I don't know if I've ever experienced anything like that, and it was really, really exciting, not just as Devin's mom and being excited for her, but just getting to see something really cool happen that, you know, was special.
There's a lot of favorite moments. I mean, for me, there's a ton.
There's so many.
Because we brought a whole bunch of songs to the table, and we, you know, had to eliminate a bunch, and that's a really hard experience. But when you're actually in the studio under the mic, and, you know, we were performing, you know, certain things kind of came alive, like the jam ending to Belong is probably one of my favorite moments on the whole record, because, you know, there's a fun story with that too, but it just, it's really at its core. We literally were just like, Matt was just, let tear loose, go ahead, fellas, just
one of my favorite moments of the Devin Worley Band is, again, two words, Sinister Brethren.
Bikers. Oops. A sunscreen fight.
Riding the shovel down the steps was interesting.
One of my favorite Devin Worley Band moments isn't really it's kind of more of an onstage moment. It was actually when we were out in Montana last year, and Daryl Worley, good old cousin Daryl. Their bus broke down, and they came in like 5 minutes before they were supposed to downbeat, and we backlined them for their show, and so it was pretty cool to make that connection with those guys. And that's kind of a cool memory to, you know, see Daryl Worley playing in front of the Devin Worley drum kit.
My favorite Devin Worley Band memory is the first tour out to Montana, when we were driving back from Montana, and shenanigans ensued.
Some ribs.
He's gonna
make you sweat. I'm gonna leak a mess.
I think he's gonna go that direction.
Well, they described it right there, but eating ribs in a hot tub.
The next morning, Jason coming out and saying, I'm going to say sorry once for anything I did last night, but then I'm not going to say it again. So listen up.
If you need an apology, this is it.
If you need an apology, this is it.
That was awful.
One of my favorite moments was when Jason met that guy, the nickname Jingles. Tell everybody the story, but
if you feel that you're deserving of an apology from me, this is where you're
at. You haven't lived.
You
eat ribs and
have a party until you eat ribs in a hot tub.
You can't even explain that. That was a thing that happened.
There's so much going on, and there's so much excitement, and even getting the demos ready and all that. It didn't feel real yet. But right there, like, waking up in the studio, the guys were still in there playing instruments, Matt was in the chair, sitting there, like, that was the big moment where I was like, this is actually happening. This is a real album that we're really making right now. This is for real. Like, that was the biggest moment for me right there.
Stuck in VIP, we got nowhere to go. Oh, yeah. Nothing to do except hang around, sitting around and waiting till the sun goes down. Now, we see the campfires round up now that the stars are shining bright. By the fire, we're winding down.